In this video, we'll learn how to install the input system in Unity Engine. More importantly, we'll learn how to install the samples that the input system provides, and we'll see how we can learn from them. This is going to be a straightforward video. I have already uploaded a theory video on the input system, so make sure to check that out. So let's get right into it. So right now we have an empty project. Since it is a package, we can only install it through the package manager. We can open the package manager by going to Window and then Package Manager. Once it loads, we can go to Packages and select Unity Registry. This way, you can filter out only packages that Unity provides. And if you scroll down, you can see the input system. If you select it, you can see the description of the package in the right. Here, you can also find links to the documentation, the changelogs, and the licenses. The latest version, as of recording this video, is 1.0.2. We can install necessary APIs by clicking the install button right here. Then Unity will install all necessary stuff for the package to work. After a while, we will get this warning message. It asks us whether we need to enable the platform backends for the input system. A backend is simply the part of the program that the users will not see. Essentially, if we choose yes, Unity Editor would restart, and this project would then start to handle input using the input system. This means the old input backends would no longer work. Don't worry too much about it, this process is completely reversible. If you choose no, the project would still use the input system package, but the backends would be disabled. This means it would use the input manager, which is the usual way of doing things, instead of the input system. But we can still change the way we handle input manually, which is what I intend to show you. So I am going to choose no, and I will show you how to set things up manually. I would also recommend you to do the same, because there is a way in which we can use both of the backends at the same time. And once you are about to ship the game, you can change it to one of your choice. So I will click no, and Unity will restart. Once it's done, you can close this window. The quickest way to check whether we have it installed is to right-click and then Create. And you can see there exists an Input Actions asset, which is a part of the input system. This is how I like to do things. You can also check it by going to Edit and then Project Settings, and there is this Input System Package tab. This is where you handle the global settings for your input, like supported devices and stuff. Now let us enable the input system backends in the player settings. You can open up player settings by going to Edit, Project Settings, and then you need to go to the Player tab. You have to then scroll down to the other settings panel, and you can scroll down a tiny bit and you can see a field called Active Input Handling. Right now it is set to the old input manager. If you click on that, you can see that you can also set it to either input system package or even both. If you have a lot of projects made earlier using the input manager, you can install the input system package and set this to both, assuming you want to use the input system APIs alongside the old ones. So in this case, we will pick both, and it will ask for a restart to apply the changes. And we say apply, and the editor will restart. Once it restarts, you can see that the active input handling is set to both. If you set it to input system and not both, there would be a red warning like this, which means input manager APIs will not work.
And that's how you install the input system. Now let's learn how we can install the samples that I mentioned earlier. In order to install the samples that the input system provides, go back to the package manager. And now you could change it back to in project, and you can see that the input system is available. Once you have successfully installed the input system, you would get this foldout called samples. So if you open it, you can see that there are tons of samples available, and then you can import them to your own projects. Make sure to view their licenses before you use them commercially. So there are several samples available, and all of them are useful in their own ways. It is totally worth it to check them out, but make sure to do so only when you need to. So where should we start? Where should we look into first? I would recommend starting from the simple demo sample that they have provided. This is the place where you should start. There is also this simple multiplayer sample, which is useful for multiplayer projects. But for now, let's look at the simple demo. I will go ahead and import the sample. and it just simply adds a folder which contains the files and classes from which you will learn from. And inside the folder you can see that there are a lot of scripts and a lot of scenes. But the place where you should start is actually the input actions asset. Let me just open it up and I will dock it right here. If you're already aware of how the input system works, try to figure this out on your own. Look into the interactions and the action types that they've used for a particular action. It is better to explore the unknown territory first and then figure out what's going on. The benefit of doing things this way is that you may learn new things which you may not have learned otherwise. I had no idea that a primary action path exists for a binding. I learned this from playing around with the samples, and it's actually pretty cool. It is a path which is set to the primary button for a device. For example, for the mouse, it's going to be the left mouse button, which is pretty cool. The next place you should look into is actually the README over here. You should read it out, it's actually pretty informative. The reason why I don't want you to do this first is I want you to explore that unknown territory. I want you to figure things out by yourself, and you learn much better that way. Next, I think you should try opening the scenes and then playing the games for yourselves. Just have fun and play around. For this sample, each of these scenes handles input differently. This one uses the input actions asset, while this one uses simple actions. This one uses player input, while this one uses states. And we have classes over here on the left for the corresponding behaviors. Another sample which I found very useful is the in-game hints sample. It's actually very easy to learn and I found it quite interesting. In-game hints contains logic for producing strings as hints in the game. It may be something that you may want in an actual game, so I'm just recommending it. Another important sample which I found very useful is called the rebinding UI sample. This is something that you may want to do in an actual commercial game, and this package simply lets you rebind your controls in the UI. Once again, I'll emphasize that all of these samples are really useful, but make sure to learn them at your own pace. That's all I have to say. And that's it. I hope this video is useful for you. If you have some tips to share or some things about the input system, make sure to comment down below. If you have any suggestions on what I should do next, or you know, if I made a mistake in this particular video, make sure to let me know as well. I actually promised this video 1 week after the theory video was made, but I couldn't get to it because I got really busy. So my sincere apologies for that. And yeah, take care. See you. Bye bye.